two, one, go.
Over the head.
Oh, no.
The 12 phase here from the men in white. And the momentum takes Freddie Stewart over. For this time, Norway can't. And it's Alex Gale. He scores! Try for Marcus Smith, this magical player, puts England in front.
Hello and welcome to O2 Inside Line Live. Welcome to England Guinness Six Nations Camp. We are live and here in Girona, just outside of Barcelona, ahead of our opening game against Italy. I'm Danny Kerr, and every Sunday ahead of the games across the campaign, we'll be giving you exclusive access from the team here in camp. Over the next half an hour or so, we'll be catching up with a couple of my mates, find out how the preparations are going and seeing what we've been up to. We'll be putting the players' skills also to the test. We want you to get involved at home too. We'd also love to hear from you and some of your questions to the lads. So get involved, drop us a question, use the hashtag #WearTheRose below. And you're going to win. The best question today is going to win a signed shirt.
Yes.
Yeah, they are. Signed by myself and the best and my amazing two guests. So drop your questions in the box below. Right, time to meet our guests. I'm joined by two absolute heartthrobs. One is... they really are. Wait till you see them. Wait till you see them. You thought you've got one. You've actually got three. You've actually got three today. First up, Exeter Chiefs legend, clutch king at the moment. Please welcome Henry Slade to the show.
Cheers for the lovely introduction.
It's great to see you, mate. You look glorious.
Thanks, mate.
We're going to invite another glorious guest. It's a guy who's absolutely flying at the moment in the Gallagher Premiership. Captain at the moment for the Northampton Saints.
Strongest tash in the game.
Top of the league. Best mo, probably in world rugby. Please welcome George Furbank, everybody. Boys, firstly, welcome to the show. Do you like the setup?
Lovely.
Yeah, wires everywhere, aren't they?
Yeah, there really are a few wires. Yeah, boys, firstly, how are you enjoying camp in Spain so far?
I'll let Ferbs do that because I haven't really done too much this week.
Yes, it's been good, to be fair. The weather's pretty nice out here, so that's made a difference from training in the wet and cold in England. So that's added a bit of motivation, but no, it's been good. It was a tough few days. Friday was pretty tough. But had a nice weekend to relax and recover.
Tans look good as well, boys. The weather has been great.
Little balcony in the bedroom is a key. Decent spot for that.
You got a balcony?
Got a balcony, yeah. I ain't
got okay, lads, let's stop that. Stop all this, please. So we're going to find out just how much you two know each other, okay? We're going to play a game of fact and fiction, okay? Two truths and one fake fact about each player. You've got to pick the fiction / fake. Understand, Henry?
Got it, mate. Roger.
Okay, so Henry, we're going to start by talking about George, okay? Which of these facts is actually fiction, not true, about George?
Far away.
Okay, fact number one. Furbs once took part in a naked calendar shoot and used a large ball hide his modesty. Fact number one. Fact number two. Let me finish. Fact number two. Furbs was a talented cricketer and was on Leicestershire's books at under-16 level. Fact number three, Ferb's great-great-grandfather was a doctor and invented the original throat lozenge. He features at the Northampton's Museum. OK, so you need to tell me which one of those is not true.
I can envisage him being good at cricket.
Yeah.
Deft with his hands.
Very good.
Very good with his hands. I can see him being naked, but probably wouldn't be a large ball.
Imagining me being naked.
Might not need a large ball.
Size three ball.
But I think size three ball.
Still,
one of those
still
mini stress balls.
Yeah. One of those ones.
Yeah, yeah.
But the third one, I think, is too random to be made up. Unless who's making up these things? You've got to be pretty fruity.
Yeah, I'll be honest, lads.
Is that you making?
I don't know the answer, so I'm as intrigued as I'm sure all our listeners are.
I'm going to say number. Was it A or number one?
That was one.
One, I'm going to say one is the fib.
So you don't think he took part in a naked calendar shoot?
Well,
George, can you reveal the answer, please?
The answer is number three. Yeah, I don't have a great grandfather who invented the lozenge.
Oh, that was too random. That's got to be that. Too random to be very well made up.
Well,
made,
well made up. Up.
Right, fair play to you.
Well played. Well played. Okay,
that's
right.
Impressive.
Now, George, it's your turn. Which of these facts is actually fiction about Henry? Okay, fact number one. Slade's great uncle played football for the mighty Pompey FC.
There's
a Pompey fan in there. Yeah? Just one of them. Okay, fact number two. Slade collects and likes to trim small bonsai trees. Quote from Henry Slade himself, "It's calming and it gives one a wonderful sense of well-being."
Interesting.
Fact number three. Slade started a dog walking club in his early years at Exeter. Countryside walks, pubs, dogs, good chat.
Good chat. On the dog with the dogs?
Debatable with the chat.
On the, number two has got to be true because I've seen your garden on Instagram. It's something you post about quite a lot and it's very neat and tidy. So I can imagine you you trimming bonsai trees in your spare time quite a lot.
Fair enough.
What was the first one?
First one was that his great uncle played football for the mighty Pompey FC.
Blue Army.
Again, that's. I feel like you're quite a good football player, aren't you? And that's got to come from somewhere, hasn't it?
Thanks, George.
Yeah. Did you go and watch Portsmouth when you were younger?
Are
you a Portsmouth fan?
I'm an Argyle fan, mate.
Did you ever watch Portsmouth play?
Up the greens, eh?
Do you know any Portsmouth players? Previous Portsmouth players?
Carney.
Yeah.
Wilson Carney.
Yeah. Good.
Good player. That's interesting. Surely you'd be a Portsmouth fan if.
No, I'm not a Portsmouth.
Great.
Okay, George, I'm going to have to push.
Sorry.
I think some people may have turned
really trying to work this
off.
One out.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with number three is the false one.
Okay, but you started the dog walking club. Yeah. Did you start a dog walking club in your early years?
I actually think with this game, all three could have been a lie because I don't think my great uncle played for Portsmouth. I don't know.
It's on Wikipedia.
Well, I don't know where that's come from.
I don't chop
bonsai trees. I don't prune bonsai trees.
So they're all false.
I never started a dog walking club. We just walk dogs sometimes.
That's a good game, Matt.
Yeah.
Nice.
Sweet.
So yeah, you won. Yeah. You won because you got it right.
Technicality.
Good game,
right.
Yeah.
Technically, you won.
Please don't blame the host, boys. I just got told to say all this. So, okay, lads, let's talk a little bit, because that game went so well. Let's talk a little bit about, obviously, we've trained hard. We have trained hard this week, but everything you're about to see now is off-field stuff, which we need to do. Now, Furbs, there's a bit of a paddle tennis clip coming up from you. Could you just explain your love for paddle and why it's so popular with the team?
Oh, shirt off.
Oh, wow. Yeah, shirts off, of course. So that's just Chez currently playing.
Yeah, well, we're hoping Ollie Chesham has got Factor 50 on because he does burn. Did you have to go tops off, or was that just when the camera?
He was on the camera.
The sun was out. It was warm.
It's making me dizzy. This.
Okay. From are those four Furbs?
The backwards cap and shades as well.
Who's the best?
Chez, to be fair, was actually pretty good the other day. Finn's quite good. He's a handy tennis player.
Yeah.
But me and Chez are actually unbeaten this day. So, yeah, Chez probably number one there. Yeah. And Robes was letting the fin down big time.
Really?
Robes has got his own paddle racket as well, and gave it large before bloke didn't move off the spot.
Did hear this? You can't have your own paddle racket and be bad at paddle, can you?
Yeah. No, he managed it. So.
Okay, a bit of a tough one to take this week, Henry. A group of lads went to watch Barcelona football play, but not all of us were there. Henry, can you explain what happened and why we all weren't there, please?
Yeah. Jamie George.
Yeah.
Skips.
Yeah.
Skips. Also, obviously got an invite to go and watch Barcelona play, and he was only allowed to bring five players along. So everyone who was keen put their hands up, put their thumb in the WhatsApp group. Names got drawn out of hat. Fairly or unfairly, I don't know. I wasn't there for the draw, so I can't tell, but I didn't get drawn. Ooh. You didn't get drawn.
Did go drawn. It was tough. The people who did get drawn weren't football fans either.
Yeah, exactly. So
Tom Pearson, Tommy Freeman, quote, don't like football.
No idea.
Oh. Yeah. Yet were seen in Barcelona with the flags giving
Sharon Vamos. Sharon Vamos. And there's been uproar in camp.
It actually hurt quite a lot because I thought myself and Jamie George come as a pair.
but obviously now he's not. Captain.
Obviously not.
I'm dust. So, Furbs, another clip of you. Maybe you got your top on, I don't know here. But this is football tennis that we've been playing a little bit of, haven't we? In the warm-ups for the back sessions.
Any clips of me or...?
Henry, I think you were stood on the sidelines most of this week, mate, if I'm honest. So you have to train to get on these clips.
Fair enough.
But Furbs, who's impressed you the most on this?
Deesh, you're probably up there, to be fair.
Thank you.
Yeah. feed the ego.
Thank you.
Mitch is pretty good. Mitch and Dinger's made a good pair.
Yeah.
And he was pretty good. But yeah, who was your partner?
Elliot Daly.
Was he... letting you down? Or?
Let me down.
Yeah. You were definitely up there. I mean, Marcus actually had a decent run. Looks like it.
Some good skills. It's actually tougher than it looks, I think, as well. Right, boys, one thing we've been doing, and this has swept the nation at the moment, the TV show The Traitors has been on. I don't know if you've watched it. If you have, it's unbelievable. We decided, Richard Wigglesworth, our backs coach, decided that the backs were going to play our very own version of The Traitors. Now, I'm not expecting either of you to reveal whether you're a traitor or a faithful. Obviously, I'm a faithful.
Obviously.
We're all faithful.
Yes. Oh, he's a big suspect. He's a big suspect.
Yeah, there's a bit of heat on George, actually. Yeah. But someone, just before we were doing this, actually, live, there's a bit of an exclusive here, there was a banishment and a murder, wasn't there? Can you explain what happened?
There was. Tommy Freeman was murdered.
Mm.
I'm not sure why. There weren't any reasons explained. And then Will Muir... was named as a suspect
out of nowhere,
and he wasn't happy about it. No. He has spent the whole of dinner moaning about it and asking for reasons as to why he's been banished, and he's a not happy man right now.
I do feel a bit bad because he's my roommate and I did vote him.
It's gonna go down well.
That is traitorous.
I might get stabbed in my sleep tonight.
Yeah. He, to be fair, he was like, I just wanted to play the game. I didn't have a chance. He didn't say a word.
He was genuinely gutted, wasn't he?
He was genuinely gutted. Well, let's keep an eye on that, because I think the traitor series is gonna roll on. It's a big week for rugby. Not just our first game of the 2024 Guinness Six Nations, but also Six Nations Full Contact has dropped on Netflix. All episodes are out now. Loads of lads are on it from last season. Here's a trailer of what you can expect from the series.
So what's it like being Golden Balls?
Six Nations is the tournament to decide the best team in Europe. Rugby is primal.
It's dog eat dog.
When you go off to a game...
I'm not going to be at war.
I feel like you are going off to war sometimes.
Embrace the fear. Embrace it all.
They've got some of the best players in world rugby, and that's what you want to play against. You want to silence them in front of their home crowd.
I need to see more energy off you, because we are the better team.
The thing is, you probably need to go through a bit more pain.
You like the challenge, don't you?
I struggle with mental health for years. I'm not afraid to say it.
Il était que c'était, vous n'avez pas le droit au moindre faux pas.
When you feel like you are an imposter or you shouldn't be where you are, that's when you start questioning yourself.
I've got a responsibility not only to my teammates, to myself, but all the people that have been there for me.
This could be the last chance, winning a trophy in the Six Nations.
We just need to make this one count.
It's business, ultimately.
And there can only be one winner.
And Six Nations Full Contact is out now on Netflix, an exclusive here, guys. We've got Netflix in the room. Can we hear it for Netflix, everyone? Now, they probably missed a trick. Well, England missed a trick last year because I wasn't involved in the Six Nations. Were you lads? Did you play? Apologies, guys. Technical glitch over here in Girona. But we are back, and the Six Nations Full Contact is out now. And guess what, guys? Netflix are here in the room today, boys.
Yeah!
Here for Netflix! They missed a trick last year. Well, maybe England missed a trick. They didn't pick me for the Six Nations, which also meant I couldn't go on this year's series, but I'm hopeful to play a starring role.
I'm sure you will.
Next year. Boys, yourself, you want to be on?
Yeah, yes, please.
Okay. Okay, the boys are kidding. Right, this is O2 Inside Line Live. I'm Danny Kerr in the heart of the England Team Hotel in Girona in Spain, as we prepare for the Six Nations, and it is game time, which you can play at home. We're going to play the back-to-front game. If you can remember this from last year in the autumn, test of skill, the ball starts behind your back, you throw it over your head, you catch it in front of yourself, you throw it back to front, boys. You get it?
Original name, yeah.
Yeah. So we've had some, everybody's had a go at this, loads of guests. Here is some of the best bits so far.
Wow. 20 seconds, as many reps as you can.
Back to front.
We're getting serious now, the crocs are off. 3, 2, 1, go.
Oh my God, what a bad start.
Ah!
Don't lose it, Marcus!
Get you!
That's a horrible start!
Oh, wow.
Oh, my.
Yeah, off the head, yeah, off the Swede, yes.
Did you say have it, Jack?
For 14, 15 times!
I saw Rachel on the weekend. He was quite smug about it.
Right, over the head, please, mate.
I don't think...
Oh, that's only bonus points for that one.
Does that count as two?
Some interesting showings there, some good, some bad. Let's have a look at the overall leaderboard and see who's doing the best. I think Rachel Burford, you'll see, with an unbelievable score of 19, set the record. It's incredible. I mean, I had a poorly bat when I did mine. I only got 8. Ben Earl and Freddie Stewart, 2, boys. That is horrific. They are professional rugby players.
Yeah, we've got to be confident.
Can't speak too soon.
They got... Yeah, let's wait and see how we go. George?
Have you got to go, Danny?
Yeah, as you can see, Henry, from the leaderboard. Sorry, he can't see. His eyes are there. I got 8. But like I say, bad back at the time. Struggled a little bit. Right, George, you're going to go first, please. Can we have 20 seconds, Nigel?
Go on, Furby.
20 seconds on the clock.
Very low ceilings.
Low ceilings, yeah. Helps if you're... Mm. Shorter. It's a bit shorter like me. Right, here we go. 3, 2, 1. Go, George. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good temper.
Fix it,
George. Watch the cameras.
Watch the cameras, whatever you do.
Okay, we're on 5. 10 seconds to go. 6, 7. That 8. I'll give you that. 9, 10. Keep going, George. Keep going. 11.
Tie.
12. 12, George. Decent attempt.
Double figures. I'm taking it.
Decent attempt. Right.
I need space.
The housewife's favourite, Henry Slade. Here we go. 20 seconds on the clock, please. 3, 2, 1. Go. 1, 2. Oh, the big back.
Big back.
I'll give you that. 3, 4, 5. That's a late reload there. 6, 7. 8. Oh, really taking your time to throw it back there. 10. 11.
12.
Is that 12 as well? Official check is...
We'll take
12. Lads, both got 12. You both got 12. Give a round of applause. 12.
Everyone's a winner.
Pretty good efforts, boys. Are you happy with that?
I don't believe we've got 19.
19 is ridiculous, isn't it?
Yeah, I'd like to see the actual footage of Burf doing that.
And how many attempts.
Yeah, I think someone's playing some trickery there.
Must be. It's a lot.
Must be the cameras.
But not fair play.
Good efforts, boys. It's not just here on O2 Inside Line Live that you're getting to know the players. There's also the England Rugby Podcast. Got a whole back catalogue in there, including... It's a decent episode of me. But the new series will be getting going again in a few weeks. But here's a reminder of who we had on the end of last year.
You're listening to the England Rugby Podcast, O2 Inside Line. I'm Freddie Stewart.
I'm Lark Davis.
I'm Courtney Laws.
I'm Sarah Beckett.
I'm Danny Kerr.
I'm Holly Aitchison.
I'm Tom Curry.
I'm Ellie Kildon.
I'm Ollie Lawrence.
Danny? So wherever you listen to your podcast, wherever you get them, make sure you're subscribed to the England Rugby Podcast O2 Inside Line to get the new series when it drops. Right, thank you very much for sending in all your fan questions. Remember, we're going to pick the best questions, going to win this shirt signed by myself and the boys. Here are a couple of the questions. Carla Lowe on YouTube. I'm going to send this one to you, Henry. If you had to be stuck on an island with one rugby player, who would it be and why?
You can come with me, Danny.
That's really cool.
We'll have a good time. We've known each other a long time. We go way back.
We do.
We could cuddle.
We could light some fires.
And, yeah, do man stuff.
Yeah. George, quickly, like one question, one person that springs to mind, who would you take?
Colsey, probably.
Nice.
Yeah, he'd keep me entertained, I reckon. Yeah. Got some good games.
Big goose as well.
Big goose.
You could always eat it.
Reasonably practical man. So.
Yeah, perfect. Okay. Henry, sorry, again to you. This is from Katzenbuero, at Katzenbuero. Great name. Henry, have you ever considered a career as a fashion model?
No.
I think you do great stuff.
Yeah, well, how does it pay, right?
You post some modelling.
I mean, I could,
haven't you?
I could. Decent. I mean, I've done bits and bobs, but never considered
there we
a
go.
Career.
Okay,
but
well.
Yeah, you never know.
There we go.
If someone's got something to fire my way, then yeah.
If you want him, get
if
at
you
him.
Want me, I'm open. I'm,
at Henry me, Slade, is it?
At Slady10.
Slady10.
Used to be a 10 back in the day, you know.
Interesting. Well, no. Okay, George. Bailey Elson on YouTube has asked, what has Jamie George's captaincy style been like so far?
It's hard to say. Like, we've not really been in a test week yet, but he delivered a pretty good message at the start of the week. And he's a lot about just being pretty free and enjoying yourself so far. So that's a pretty nice message to deliver, really.
It really is. I think he's been great. He's going to do a great job. Thank you so much for the questions. Boys, could you just sign the shirt now?
Absolutely.
Whilst we do a little drum roll and we decide the best question. The best question we have decided to give it to, and this shirt's going to come to you, Carla Lowe. The shirt's yours. Maybe we even write it to Carla. We could personalise that. Be nice, wouldn't it? Carla, would you like that?
Yeah.
I think you would. Okay. Last couple from me, boys. 6 days till our Six Nations campaign properly kicks off. What does the rest of the week look like for us now, Ferbs?
We've got a pretty tough day's training on Tuesday, I think. Well, we've got a bit of training tomorrow, a tough day on Tuesday. A bit of downtime on Wednesday, or maybe a meal out on Tuesday night.
Which would
be nice. Some good restaurants in Girona, I think, so that'll be good fun. A bit of downtime Wednesday, maybe a bit of paddle again.
Top of the town.
Yeah, get on that balcony. And then Thursday training again, and then travel to Rome from there.
Will you be shaping the mow-in for the game?
Probably.
Brilliant. And Henry, we're going to a pretty amazing stadium. I know we've played there a few times. Head to Stadio Olimpico to take on Italy. What's your best or your favourite memories of that stadium, or why is it so special?
It's a special stadium. Obviously, Italy's full of culture. It's a very different environment to what we're used to. Obviously, you drive in the bus, you go under the stadium, you get into the change rooms, you've got the Roma football car seats, you change in, you walk out, you actually walk up steps to the pitch. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool, yeah, I'm excited for it.
It's exciting times, we can't wait. Firstly, Henry and George, thank you so much for joining us. Can I have a round of applause for Henry and George?
Yes.
Thank you. Two glorious looking guests, aren't they? Unfortunately, that's it from us here in Girona. Don't forget to join us next Sunday night. We'll be in camp following our first game against Italy, previewing the week against Wales, our first home game of the Guinness Six Nations. Remember to follow All England Rugby socials and use hashtag WearTheRose to get involved where you can. Thank you for watching. We will see you next week. Adios.
DC!